Well, this has been a difficult season for Yulia Lipnitskaya. Her season's best scores 25 points below her personal best from last season. She has struggled with some of her jumps, both in the short and the free programs, and just doesn't look like she enjoys competing this season. And she's had to struggle with all the fame that came her way after her performance in the team event at the Sochi Olympics.
Well, they say the only thing you should take on the ice are your skates and your costume, and leave the luggage at the hotel. And when she does that, she has a lot to offer. And you can see the pop on both of those jumps. They're not huge jumps, but they're nice to look at. They're good, quick elevation. And her secret, that tight, tight spin in the air. Jump combination, the double axel triple toe, that double axel, the same jump that she fell in earlier, and she's recovering from that fall much better than Anna Pogorelia did. And that timing off on that triple flip attempt, that single is really going to hurt her score-wise.
And she struggled with the flip and the short, getting an edge call on it. And you can't help but wonder if that hasn't got in her head. She's thinking about correcting it on the fly, which is practically impossible to do.
The reigning world silver medalist, obviously in trouble here, continues to struggle with the big jumps this season. Yulia was second after the short, but she's not going to be able to hold down that spot after that free skate.
And they're like little computers out there, and they know exactly what's happening to them on the scoreboard, as well as the judges do. And you could see the disappointment halfway through after the second mistake when she knew the podium is...
Yeah, they've got that technical tracker in their head.
Oh, such a tough season for her at last year's Grand Prix final. She finished with a silver medal, and then in Sochi won gold in the team competition. And back inside the Barcelona International Convention Center, looking at a very distraught Yulia Lipnitskaya, who had her worst skate of the season, I would say.
Yeah, and it was difficult to watch because you see the potential not only here today in the first half of the program, but in general for her. And the moments of brilliance are there, and the memories of Sochi are there, but that fall was completely unnecessary. She has awful technique on her double axel, I had to say it, and it just came up and it got her that time.
And we forget really how young these girls are, and their bodies are growing and changing all the time. And even the tiniest little bit of growth can throw your timing off so badly, you don't know where you are.
But I can't help to think that if she just came back next year with some choreographic patience, and I just, as soon as my eye settles on a beautiful moment from her, she changes it.
It's gone.
And
yeah.
So you never get to see the beauty in the potential beauty of her skating.
She's capable of some incredible scores. Her personal best in the free skate is about 142 points.
And it depends on whether or not the judges decide to really penalize that entrance of some of the jumps. Are you on the inside edge or are you on the outside edge? We all know how wide a blade is. Mm-hmm. And it sounds like you all just make sure you're on the inside edge, but... That's so hard. You know, go ahead and change the way you talk, how you write your name, how you swing your golf club. Just go change it, would you? It's hard.
She was in second place after the short, a point back of first. And there you see with one skater left to come here in Barcelona, she sits in fourth place. Well, now let's join PJ, who's with the leader at the moment, Yulia Lipnitskaya's teammate.